Gusto ko lang sana na inyong matatandaan ang isang napakaganda pong proverb. And it says that in anything, especially when we see the earth and the bounties that have been given to us by God, the divine, by Allah, by Bathala, that we cannot really love this or love anything that we do not fully understand. Hindi natin pwedeng mahalin ang bagay na hindi natin nauunawaan ng lubos. Correct? Kung hindi nyo nauunawaan yung girlfriend o boyfriend nyo, hindi nyo siguro sila talaga maging mahal. But the same for our families. If we do not really understand who are within our circle, we will not really be able to say that we love them. And that is the same with the earth. And that is the same with the bounties and the gifts of nature that we all depend on life on. The water, the seas, the air, the mountains, the land. Everything that gives us food, that sustains us, that makes us whole as human beings and as communities and as countries. So tandaan po ninyo ang kasabihan na hindi natin nauunawaan ang bagay kung hindi natin nauunawaan ang isang bagay, hindi natin yung pwede mamahalin ng lubos. At yung hindi natin minamahal na lubos, hindi rin natin pwede ipagtanggol na lubos. What we're saying is that you cannot also protect what you do not really love. And so today, if we speak of ethical, effective, and environmental leadership, we return to the understanding of what really governs all of us. And it is the laws of nature. It is the laws of what God has given all of us to enjoy. So that we could always bequeath this to future generations. Kung hindi natin ito nauunawaan ang global warming, hindi nauunawaan natin ang deforestation, ang pollution sa Manila Bay, sa Pasig River, kung anong nangyayari sa pollution ng Metro Manila, kung hindi natin yan nauunawaan, hindi natin pwedeng sabihin na minamahal natin ang ating kalikasan at kapaligiran. Correct? At kung hindi natin mamahalin ang kapaligiran at ang kalikasan na sadyang ibinigay ng Poong May Kapal sa ating lahat, hindi rin natin maipagtanggol ito ng mabuti at maayos. And that is the same for government, and that is the same for leadership. That is the same for citizenship. If we do not understand what it is we should be responsible for, then we will not be able to really love our being Filipinos. And if we cannot love our being Filipinos and who we are as citizens of this beautiful land we call the Philippines, and this beautiful environment that God has given for all of us, then we will not be able to really protect it. Protect it against the evil that is descending in all of the communities and the country as even as we speak. Even as we speak, Sierra Madre is being deforested. Even as we speak, there are tons and tons of waste and industrial poisons and toxic chemicals that are being spilled in the Manila Bay and Pasig River. Every day, and this year, this is the 10th anniversary of the Clean Air Act, which we worked on, and I authored as congressman in 1998, 1999. It was signed by President Estrada in 1999. But we have to look at what it is that is at stake, because that is our lives and the support systems, the ecology. And ecology is made up of four components, right? Population, tao, environment, yung kalikasan at yung kapaligiran. Pangatlo, technology, at ang pang-apat, governance, yung pangangasiwa at pamamalakad ng ating gobyerno at ng ating mga communities. And so this is really what we really have to understand. And I hope that you will be able to truly live out this being Filipinos and young Filipinos at that, to understand that you have a stake in the future of this country. And I will begin and end with this line as well. You know Francisco Balagtas, yes? He wrote Florante at Laura. At siya yung makatang nagbigay sa atin ng mga magagandang mga aralin na si Jose Rizal at si Apolinario Mabini at iba nating mga bayani. Ito ang mga ginamit nila when they went to Europe, when they went on exile. They read the works of Francisco Balagtas. And what he wrote many, many, many years ago, even before Rizal and Mabini and our other heroes, is still very applicable to us today and to the theme of leadership. Ethical, effective, and environmental leadership. At ang sinabi niya ito, stanza 14, from Florante at Laura. Anyone knows? Sa loob at labas ng bayan kong sawi, kaliluhay siyang nangyayaring hari. Kagaling at bait ay nalulugami, ininis at inilibing sa dusa at pighati. At isasalin natin ito sa wikang Ingles, inside and outside the suffering country, treachery is king. Goodness and excellence are weakened and buried in anguish and misery. Treachery, sa Tagalog, sa wikang Pilipino, paglilinlang, pandaraya, pandarambong, lahat na nakakasama sa lipunan at sa kalikasan at sa ating mga sarili, sa diwa natin bilang Pilipino at bilang mga tao. That is treachery. But if treachery is king, then your forests get deforested, and your seas and rivers get polluted, and your mountains are exploited for all of their minerals, and we forget that these are what give us life. But treachery is king when we corrupt the very soul of a country. Treachery is king, katiwalian. Treachery is king when we do not have as much faith anymore in government. Kung nawawalan tayo ng pag-asa, nawawalan tayo ng tiwala sa ating mga pinuno, sa ating mga namumuno at sa ating mga institusyon ng ating pamahalaan. And that is what's happening now. I'm sure you agree with that. In many respects, treachery is king. That is why 3,000 to 4,000 Filipinos leave the country every day. Nag-iibang bansa. Kasi hinahanap yung kapalaran na hindi nila mahanap sa ngayon sa ating sariling bayan. Nakakalungkot, hindi ba po? Nakakalungkot kung tayo na mga Pilipino at mamamayan, kayo, you will inherit this country. How many of you will vote in 2010? How many of you are registered to vote in 2010? How many of you still need to register to vote in 2010? There you go.